give him a big round of applause. Thank you.
Good night, day, good night, you, and we come tell you. Good night, day. Good night, day, good night, day, and we come tell you. Good night, day. Good night, day, good night, you, and we come tell you. Good night, day. Good night, day, good night, you, and we come tell you. Good night, day. Good night, people, good night, day, and we come tell you. Good night, day. Say good night to you. You wanna say good night to me? How do you do? How do you do? Yeah. I want to tell you a secret. I grew up with my grandmother, and anytime I go by her house, well, she's deceased now, but back then, I would go. I say ma, I call her ma, and I would say, how you do? And she said, by me do. That if she feels well or she feels okay. She doesn't feel too well, she said, by me not do. So I'm going to ask you, how you do?
By me do.
You do, that means you feel good. Yeah. If you say you not do, that means you don't feel well. Once again, how you do?
By me do.
You do, good. Amen. My name is Jeggae. I'm from Guyana originally. And I'm not sure if Chris told you were coming to a concert or whatever it is. But I know this is not a concert. We're going to have a party. Right? Anybody here came with a cane or a walker? Because if you did, you were going to be the toast of the party. And I don't see any, so we are going to be partying. What I'm going to be doing is some kweh songs. Some Guyanese pre-wedding ceremonies. Any Guyanese in the audience? Oh, there's the Guyanese over there. Guyanese? Which part of Guyana?
Georgetown.
Oh, you're a city guy, so he doesn't know anything about Georgetown. You gotta grow up in the countryside, you know. No, I'm only kidding. Yeah. But I'm from Victoria, right? Yeah. Up the East Coast, Demerara. Now, kweh is kind of unique to Guyana. It's actually a tradition that was handed down from our African ancestors, and sometimes they celebrate for a week prior to the wedding. And of course, you know, celebrating a week, cooking, and buying all those drinks. So we kind of cut it down to one night, because it can be very expensive. Maybe Kay can afford 1 week, but we can only afford one night. So we would do it the night before the wedding. And it is an opportunity for the two families to meet, to get to know each other. Because if you think about it, if you're living in Brooklyn and you're going to school somewhere, let's say in East New York, those are the people you're going to kind of associate with. Those are the people you're going to meet. Or once you start working, you tend to get involved, get married to somebody who you went to school with, who you work with, who you socialize with. Right? So the villages being close to each other, you get married from somebody in your village or from the village next door. And as I was walking down coming from the back, that's one of the songs they would do, moving from one village to the other village. And I'll tell you what happened to my kweh back in Guyana. It was a Friday night, and it was about 9 o'clock at night, and some of my friends got together. My wife-to-be at the time lived 1 mile away in Golden Grove. I live in Victoria. And we marched from Victoria to Golden Grove to her house, and that's where the kweh continued. Once I got to her house, they had to invite me into the home, right? And there are certain songs that are being sung while this is going on. And once I enter the home, I have to go look for her, because they hide her somewhere in the building. Sometimes she sits right there with an old wig and an old dress and some kind of disguise, and I'm walking right past her. Or sometimes they put her somewhere, some way down in the back in the bushes. Because if you don't find her, well, of course, there can't be no wedding. So you have to find her, and you bring her out, and you display her to everybody, and then sometimes you'll actually pay in some cultures, what they call it, like a dowry, where you will pay for the bride. And there are certain songs that are being sung where they teach both the bride and the groom about marriage life, how they should operate in the home and in the kitchen, and of course in the bedroom, in the bedroom, because that's a big part of it. And then if the youngsters get married, they might not know all the things, so we would get some of the old family members, some of the elders in the family. And sometimes they would be gyrating and they would be moving. So we'll be doing some of that in a few minutes. Now Chris told me I have 10 minutes, you said, Chris? Oh, you said 10 hours? Oh, 10 minutes. So I was singing Gunaite as I was coming down. So we can actually do a little kweh ceremony here. And I'm asking for 5 volunteers. You know, when we say volunteers, we don't really wait for you to come up. We just pick people up.
Army style.
Yeah. And I see she's making notes. Just remember. And I'm asking for volunteers over on the other side. Just 2 more from the other side. Yes. Now we can go on stage. This is our show. Now imagine we're coming down from Victoria, we're going to the Golden Grove. And you know, there's another thing. When I first came to this country, I think it was one of these Mother's Day or something, and somebody said, "Are you not going to buy some flowers?" I said, "Where I'm from, we don't buy flowers. We go, we break some flowers in the neighbor's yard." And then they said, "What are you doing?" "You wait till the night when they go to sleep, and then you go and you break them." So we would normally be walking down the street, and you break flowers and bushes. And as you're coming down, imagine you have these flowers in your hand, and you're coming down the street. Coming down with a bunch of roses, coming down with a... And of course, the music is playing, so you'll be moving, right? So, coming down with a bunch of roses, coming down. Now, the other thing is, at one time, there were no drums. We didn't use the drum. We would use the feet, because the drums were taken away, right? So, we're going to be going around the circle, and I'm not going to play the drum, and you're going to be all going to follow. Coming down with a bunch of roses, coming down. Coming down with a bunch of roses, coming down, coming down. Oh. Coming down with a bunch of roses, coming down. I'm not the only one singing. Coming down with a bunch of roses, coming down. Oh. Coming down with a bunch of roses, coming down. The house, here we're gonna say, what's your name?
Soretta.
Okay, Soretta is the bride to be. Tell the Soretta family to close their door and window. Jeggae coming down to take away their daughter. Tell Soretta family to close them door and window. And they're gonna open the door to invite me. Open the door, let the man come in. All we are one family. Open the door, let the man come in. I wonder where me lover there, such am go find him. I wonder where me lover there,
such am go find
him. I wonder where me surrender there,
such am go. Eventually, I find out. Right? So whether you come up. I'm going to display her. Is she beautiful? Hey, mama, me find one sweet woman. Alam ke malang dam gonda. Hey, mama, me find one sweet woman. Alam ke it actually said Harlem, you know, Hall, carry him, carry her, along down, this long road, and he said, go knock him. I said, what did knock him mean? You know, hit him, knock him, but that's what it said. Harlem came along down, hey mama, we find my feet to my Harlem came along down. While we have around here, we're going to get four strong young men or young women, and they will actually lift her up. We're not going to do that right now. We're going to actually lift her up, and I'm displaying her. Right? And then I'm going to ask her a question. So if the one make you married, ya bembe ya. So if the one make you married,
yeah.
Hey, so if the one make you married,
yeah.
So, but you can answer. Because you should know. Right? So if the one make you married, ya bembe ya. And the money make you married, bembe. Hey, so if the one make you married. Make you married, baby. Oh, love make you married. Do you mind telling us why you married? That's a good one. Yeah, good. So we're gonna ask her, and we're gonna ask her question the guy why he decided to get married. So you can put away the chair. No, you baby want to insert this stuff. And of course she has to show us what she can do. Well, that can mean anything. Science, show me your science. Show me your science. Well, I don't know why they call it science. You're not a scientist. But if you show your science, then you gotta show some gyrations. Show me your science. Are you satisfied with that?
one of the older female members to show up, because sometimes some people so they got no room. But imagine, so we're comfortable with that. So we will now ask the bridegroom to show me his signs. Darrell. But we're gonna ask him for the signs, we're gonna ask him for something different. Darrell, show me your first wine, so we're gonna ask him for the last one. But we're not gonna ask that way, we're gonna ask
Ralph Allen. Yes.
We're gonna introduce Allen. Allen, show me your last wine, this is a crash course in the Christmas ceremony. As we get ready to leave, we gotta sing, nation, away them, nation, nation, away them there. Nation, away them, nation, away them there. All of we are one generation, nation, away them there. Nation, away them, nation.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.